Okay, so we are looking at description logics and we are interested in computing entailments and in particular we want to answer the question that does the knowledge base entail and we want a algorithm for doing that. So, the first thing we will do is that we will assume that these are in normalized form. So, what is a normalized form? A normalized form essentially says that it is an AND in which there may be a series of all statements. So, for example, for every role, for example, R 1, it will have some concept D 1, but for another role R 2, it will have some concept D 2, but for every role it will have only one occurrence of that all role fillers are of this kind, because we have combined those. Likewise, for every occurrence of exists, let us say R 3, there will be some N 3 which would be talking about R 3, and R 3. Or exists, let us say N 1 for R 1 and so on. So, exactly one exist statement for every role and exactly one all statement for every role, and no duplication of atomic concepts. So, atomic 1, atomic 2 and so on. So, if we have something in this forms, and of course whatever is fills we do not do much, we just leave it as it is. So, whatever fill statements are there, they are there. So, we assume that the two concepts that we are talking about D and E are in this normalized form essentially. So, there are no compound definitions inside, there is exactly one occurrence for every all for every role for any every kind of description essentially. So, the algorithm that we are looking at is called structure matching. And it assumes that the inputs are in normalized form essentially. Once you have converted the inputs into normalized form, then simply by looking at the two formulas, we can decide this essentially. So, what is the basic idea of structure matching? So, if this concept E is described in a normalized form as something like this E 1, E 2, E r, and my concept D is likewise described in normalized form as D 1, D 2, let us say D p. The structure matching algorithm says that for every E I in the super concept, so which is E in this example, there must exist what we can call as matching D j in D. So, there must be some concept here, and this is a match that we are looking of. And we are saying that for every EI in my description of the super concept, I must be able to find a corresponding DJ in my sub concept essentially, or the subsumed concept essentially. So, let me first illustrate this with a figure, and then we will talk about what do we mean by this matching. All we need to do now is to define what do we mean by matching. And then we have this algorithm. This algorithm is very straightforward. The algorithm is simply this, that if you are trying to show that D is subsumed by E, you first convert D and E into their normalized forms, and then look at all the components of the super concept, which is E. So, which are E1, E2 up to ER in this example, and for every one of them you must find a matching component in the sub concept. If you can find that, then you are done essentially. So, let us look at this process at a higher level first, and then we will look at this what do we mean by matching. So, in structure matching, we said that for every EI in E, find a DJ in D essentially. And what are we looking for? We are looking for a DJ which is recursively subsumed by EI. That is all we are looking for. This is our notion of matching, that there is a component which is subsumed essentially. So, if our description is normalized and we can establish component wide subsumption, then we can establish subsumption essentially. So, what does this mean in terms of the domain? So, let us say this is our domain D, and let us say for example sake that E is described by and E1 and E2. Let us say there are only two components for simplicity, and let us say D is described by D1, D2, D3 and D4, let us say. Now, let me just, since I do not have space, or I will create space D3, D4, and this is my domain. Let us say this is a domain D. So, let me actually use a different color here. So, let us first describe E. What is the concept E? The concept E is, remember, this is normalized. We have broken it down to its absolute bare basics essentially. There are no compound concepts inside, there are no multiple occurrences of any name. For every role there is only one occurrence of all, and for every role there is one occurrence of exist, and things like that essentially. So, it is all broken down. So, in the end, in this very simple concept, we have found that this concept E is described by two concepts. So, this is E1 and this is E2, and the intersection is E1 comma this and E1 E2 essentially. So I am not shading the intersection here, but okay, maybe we can, does not matter. So this is a concept E which is described by two subcomponents E1 and E2. So by the semantics of the AND statement, we have to take the intersection of the two concepts E1 and E2 essentially. Now what is my algorithm saying? That for every EI in E, find a matching DJ in D essentially. So and we have also said that by matching we mean that you find a sub concept essentially. So there must be some component in D which is a sub component, sub concept for that EI essentially. So let us take E1 essentially. So let us just for argument's sake say that E1 matches D2 and let us say E2 matches D4 essentially, okay, without loss of generality we can say that. So what are we, what do we mean by matching now? By matching we mean that D2 must be subsumed by E1 essentially. So my D2 must be somewhere inside this D2, and likewise my D4 must be somewhere inside E4. Let us say this is it. My algorithm is saying that if you can find for every EI a matching DJ, then you are done. Then you can answer yes that the concept D is subsumed by the concept E essentially. What is the concept D? We have not drawn the concept D yet. All we have drawn is a part of the concept D which is piecewise subsumed by the concept E essentially. So if you look at this shaded part here, you can clearly see that this concept, let us call this AND D2 D4, you can see that this is subsumed by E. Why is it subsumed by E? Because D2 is subsumed by E1 and D4 is subsumed by E2. So the intersection of D2 and D4 is subsumed by the intersection of E1 and E2 essentially. And you can see that D is subsumed in term by this concept. Why is that? It is simply because D is more specialized than this concept, which let us call it D2 D4. D is more specialized than D2 D4 because D says that it must be a D2, it must be a D4, which means it must lie within this shaded blue area. In addition, it is a D1 and a D3 also. What are D1 and D2? We do not care essentially. So if let us say this was D1 and this was D3, then what is my concept D? My concept D is the intersection of these four blue circles essentially, which is this. That is my concept D. What have we said? We have said that this concept D is subsumed by the concept E. What is the E concept? That is the one with the shaded red region essentially, with those red dashed lines essentially. So clearly the concept D falls within the concept E, and we do not really care about what happens to D1 and D3, because we have said that as long as we can find for each EI a matching DJ, we are done essentially. So if we can show that this DJ, so what do we need? Because d 2 is subsumed by e 1. Why is d 2 subsumed by e 1? Because the image of d 2 is a subset of the image of e 1, and likewise d 4 is subsumed by e 2. So, all we now need to do is to, how do we define this notion of matching of subsumption for different kinds of components that we have in the normalized form essentially. So, normalized form has AND, ALL, fills, exists and so on essentially. So, the matching part, that is not so hard. If E I and D I are atomic, which means that they are not broken up, they are the names of some concepts, then they must be same. Only then they are matching essentially. 2, if E I is of the form fills some role, some constant A. Remember, we are looking for a sub concept essentially, and if one of the things we know about the concept E is that it fills, it is related to A by the role R, then D also better be related to the A by the role R. So, for example, if you are talking about all the people who voted for Kejriwal is one of the components, let us say EI stands for voted for Kejriwal, then if you have to be a subclass of all those that concept, you also better have voted for Kejriwal essentially, which is then straightforward. Then DJ must be the same, only then can the concept D. So, DJ is just a component in D. So, if D is to be subsumed by E, then if E says that one of the things about E is that they voted for Kejriwal, then one of the things about D must also be that they voted for Kejriwal. So, those are the simpler cases. Then let us look at exists. If E I is equal to exists N R, then what should D J be? You must be able to find a DJ or a component which is related by the same role using the exist statement, and m should be greater than or equal to n. So, for example, if one of the things about your description, let us say we are describing a family of some kind, and somewhere we say that the family D, let us call it, one of the descriptions is that they have at least 2 children essentially, then the family E says they have at least 3 children essentially, then you can see that the people who have at least 3 children are a type of family who have at least 2 children. So, exists M R is a type of exists N R as long as M is greater than R essentially. So, if you can find some such thing, then you have ordered some subsumption. So, in the special case, where E I is equal to exists 1 R, then D J can be fills or some constant let us say a 2 or whatever, does not matter, as long as it is a constant essentially. Why is this? Because the super concept says that you have at least 1 role filler, The subconcept is saying that there is a role filler I know, which is A2 in this case, which is equivalent to saying that there is at least one role filler essentially, right. So, a concept. So, for example, if you say that the set of all peoples who have at least one bank account essentially, and then you say Suresh has a bank account in SBI essentially, then obviously Suresh would belong to the set of all people who have at least one bank account. So, this pattern we will allow to match essentially, but otherwise if we say that there is a set of all people who have at least two bank accounts and then Suresh has got three bank accounts, then obviously Suresh will also fall into that category. So, both these patterns are allowed. And finally, if EI is of the form all R D, let us call it E prime, then DJ must be of the form all R D prime such that recursively D prime is subsumed by E prime. So, as an example, let us say R is child and E is doctor, it is a class. So, child will have this. So, EI is saying that all children are doctor. Then if I have D prime which says that all children are surgeons, and somewhere in my definition, okay. So, since I have normalized form, I cannot say surgeon here, but I must fill in the definition of surgeon, which could be and doctor. So, let us say not surgeon, but female, just an example. So, if DJ is says that all your children are female doctors and EI says that all your children are doctors, then obviously DJ is a subclass of EI essentially, because EI is all those people whose children are doctors and DJ is all those people whose children are female doctors essentially. So, obviously they are also doctors, so they belong to the same class essentially. So, now we have taken care of all the concept forming operators. So, we have this nice simple algorithm in which you convert everything into normalized form, then do a piecewise matching, and then for every EI in the super concept, if you can find a matching DJ in the sub concept, then you can answer that yes, the concept D is subsumed by the concept E essentially. And you can, if you look at inspect this, if you look at this algorithm, you can see that it simply you are already converted into normalized form, which may lead to some little bit of expansion possibly, or but it could also lead to contraction. But once you have the two formulas in normalized form, you are simply looking at them one by one and scanning the other formula for a matching component essentially. So, if the second formula has length n, at the most you may have to scan the second formula n times essentially, but it is only dependent on the length of this formula essentially. It does not matter what the other statements in your knowledge base are essentially. So, you can answer a specific question simply by inspecting the two formulas, and that is why this algorithm is called structure matching essentially. Okay. So, the next time when we meet, we will see how we can use this structure matching to take a knowledge base and automatically construct a taxonomy out of that essentially. Okay. So, when we talked about frames, we said that it is up to the user to define what is an is a relationship or what is the instance of relationship. So, the user had to make that entry, that you have to say that a white elephant is an elephant essentially. But now we will see that if you give descriptions for all the concepts that you are talking about, All you have to do is to give the set of descriptions, then you can have an algorithm which will automatically construct the taxonomy for you essentially. And that is because the is a relationship or the subsumption relationship now has a logical basis essentially, and we can simply exploit this fact and construct the taxonomy automatically. At least, so let's say exists two. Let's say C stands for children, and exists three children. So this set below is a type of set above essentially. So if this is EI and this is DJ, you can see that DJ is subsumed by EI. If you have at least these three children, then you also belong to the set of people who have at least two children. So it should be greater than. Okay, so we will stop here. In the next class when we meet, we will take it up from here and see how structure matching can be used to automatically construct taxonomies.